Okay, so hello there. It's probably been a while. I don't remember when I last made the video, but today is Tuesday, June 7th, 2022, 6:18 p.m. Pacific time. Hope you're doing well. Hope you had a good day, and I hope that you went to vote if you did. And I got my little I voted sticker. So I feel like the Lord wants me to get on here and share kind of a timeline that He has given me lately, just so that I maybe it's for me. Some of these videos are for me, but I'm not saying they're for me, but of course they're for you. And hopefully this will give you hope, because this gives me great hope, okay? So I'm just going to try to relax and try to share with you what God has shown me in the spirit. And Lord, thank you for this time together with your word and with the people viewing this video and with what you've given me, I believe. And hopefully this is going to give people a lot of hope. Now, I don't know who out there of you that's viewing is into politics or into watching the news and what's going on with our country, but I've been watching a long time, and I've been fighting in the spirit. I've been fighting something that I never knew and realized that I would ever come to do, and that is to speak from my heart and to fight for what I believe is what I believe, okay? Now, everybody has their views. And so, one thing about America is that we're supposed to be able to share our views with each other. And a lot of times, those views that we have are not viewed by other people. And so, we get into this boxing match, so to speak. And, you know, I don't know if you know that I've had to be very careful with what I say on these videos, because if you say the wrong word, if you say the wrong thing, that could get you banned and shut down. So I will continue to be careful. I will continue to comply as much as I know and, you know, okay, I'm going to go along with the program. I don't want to get kicked off, because then my voice will be shut down. Now, I should get into some of this with views on some people that have got shut down, and then they went over to the other social medias, which is totally fine. I'm probably there, but I'm not doing them, working them like I am Twitter. But Twitter's my main thing, and it has been for a while, and that's just where God has me. And so I wasn't planning to say this, but it needs to be said, okay? How many conservatives have just put up the white flag because it got too hard, or people got banned from Twitter? Now, that's fine, whatever, okay? And honestly, it's exhausting, okay? But we are fighting for what we believe on here, and sometimes that entails bringing what you believe up to the authorities, to hold them accountable, to speak to them. And you're not going to find a lot of people on the other social medias. You're not going to be able to talk back or tell Nancy Pelosi what you think, okay? And whether she reads what I think or not, who knows? Maybe she doesn't. But it's like, for so long we never had a platform to be able to share our hearts and speak, and so now Twitter came along, and there's other social media that frankly I can't say much on. Facebook, that's like I post a lot of flowers and horses and beautiful, just because it's like it's great to have a place where, well, you can't speak over there at all. And that's fine, because maybe a lot of family members are not into what you're into and what you're fighting for on Twitter or whatever. But anyway, I wasn't going to get into that. No, I should talk more about that. But, you know, conservatives don't just don't, like, if you're going to go to the other, if you're going to go to the other platforms, that's fine. I'm over there, but I still don't have a blue check over there. I still don't have a verified account over there. You know what I mean? So that's fine. And you know, sometimes the way God uses me is that He has suspended me, not in the air, like above anybody, but just suspended me from, like, a lot of things to where that's fine with me. And I know that you might be watching this, you might, what in the heck is she saying? Okay, so hang with me. But this first thing was, this is before I got really fed up completely. I'm always fed up with what's going on, but God told me it's going to start being supernatural from here on out. And see, the Word of God, it's where the Word of God is. The Word of God is the Word of God. And, you know, we know, like, if you read the book of Acts, if you read the Gospels and all through the Bible, God is a supernatural God. He's a God of love. He's a God of absolutes. He's absolute, okay, God. Now, He says the anointing destroys yokes. The power of the Holy Spirit, fill us with your Holy Spirit. I'm probably going to pray in here too. But the supernatural, I was driving my car. A lot of times the Lord will give me things while I'm driving my car, because I get in there and I put the worship music on and I'm relaxed and I'm worshiping the Lord in the Spirit of Truth. So that was about, this was May 20th, and I figured it out. It was like about 18 days ago. He said, the supernatural is coming. Now we know in the Bible you got to be careful about some things supernaturally, etc., about some things, you know, we don't follow after signs and wonders, etc. But He did say that signs and wonders would follow the believer and the Word of God, okay? So we probably have not even touched we have not, as the body of Christ, even gone there, like, minutely. And He's probably up there tapping His shoe and going, when are you going to get with the program, people? There's other people, pastors maybe even, that will downplay the supernatural and in the spirit. And, you know, I know that there's one very strong pastor. I totally disagree with him. And I'm not going to name his names, because I think some people, they're going to try to put curses on you by their so-called prayer. So I take authority over curses, hexes, vexes, spells, even from Christians, even from pastors, okay? You know, a lot of witchcraft going on with people, even in their homes, talking and gossiping about people and giving their opinion. Your opinions are fine and great, but you should be careful about sharing over and over and over about something just because you have nothing else to do with your life and you need to gossip with somebody about what happened today with so-and-so and so-and-so. Be careful that you're not putting word curses on people and on yourself, because they will fly back on you, okay? They could fly back on you. Okay, so that was one thing that happened, and this was 18 days ago. Now, the Lord says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not. We have to do this all the time with the Lord. Lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct thy paths. Proverbs 3, 5 and 6, 5 through 6. Now, this is all on my Twitter account, and it's all on the pinned at the top. If you want to hunt for it, it's up there. Now, after that, I posted, be healed, and I say that now, be healed, whoever you are watching this video, be healed in Jesus' name, be delivered in Jesus' name, be set free in Jesus' name. And I'm going to add a few things throughout the time on here. God is overriding some things because that is what He does. I wrote that on June 6th. Now, let me see here. I got Oh, wow. I'm going to have to go through. Oh, I see. Okay, hold on. I got another thread over here, and then I'm going to try to combine it. Okay, hold on a minute. God is overriding some things in the earth and in the country, because that is what he does. You see, God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. We're a big body of Christ. We are a huge body of Christ. We don't talk among ourselves too much. Okay, we go to our whosoever will go to their individual church, blah, blah, blah. Okay, but on the whole, the body of Christ is huge in the earth, okay? And he sees us as one body, not Catholic, not Protestant, not all these denominations. He sees us as one body in Christ, okay? God raised Jesus from the dead. I'm reading from my Twitter account on June 6th. Jesus raised, I misspelled Jesus, I just noticed that. We don't have an edit button on Twitter, so I can't go back and, I could delete that and then rewrite it, but people know what I'm saying. Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. Remember that in the Bible? So, not only God the Father raised Jesus Christ from the dead, but before he died, Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. Now, verse Romans 8:11, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you as a Christian, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you. So first of all, okay, I'm just going to keep going here. God is doing a new thing. June 6th, that was yesterday. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and ye are complete in him. Each person that receives Christ into their lives and becomes, you know, a believer, in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily in him, and ye are complete in him. You are complete in him, but we, which is the head of all principality and power, Colossians 2:9-10. He, no matter where you are in your stage in your walk with the Lord, whether it's the first day you accepted Jesus Christ into your life, or whether you're 100 years old in the Lord, so to speak, I'm you know, exaggerating there. Okay, now this is something God gave me, and I put this June 5th, not yesterday, but the day before. This video, it's on my YouTube, a word from God for the body of Christ for every believer. And I didn't watch that before I made this video, so you might want to watch it. But it's a simple thing, and God gave this to me the other day when I was driving my car. He just came upon me and he showed me, wow, how amazing the body of Christ is. Now, the body of Christ is all over the world. The body of Christ is all over America, okay? And there are homeless people who are believers, and they're just where they're at right now. It is what it is, okay? And something happened to where the devil, okay, the spirit of poverty, we take authority over that right now in Jesus' name. But I'm going to keep going because it's part of the whole thing, okay? But he gave me this. He said, you know, in the book of Acts, and I should have looked this up. I can't do that right now. I'll try to do it before the next video. Or Peter, I think, even his shadow healed people. The shadow of Peter. I thought it was Paul when I was hearing from God. I thought it was Paul, but then I read it was from Peter. So anyway, it doesn't mean that Peter's the only one. That means that every believer who has the fullness of Jesus Christ, the Godhead bodily in you, that anointing is in him, not you. That anointing is on him, not you. And yeah, we could be doing things that are hindering his anointing. But you know, God told me, he said, speak it, proclaim it for every single believer in this earth, on this continent, in the world. every believer that the shadow of even the car would extend out into the homes they drive by, into the cities and the towns. I'm sorry, but God gave me this, okay? You can believe it or you don't have to. It doesn't matter whether you believe it or not. God gave this to me, and I believe it, okay? Because things are getting so bad, okay, with so many horrible things happening in the world and people suffering and the economy and the gas prices, etc. God is going to override these things, okay? He is a God of promises, okay? He said he will never leave us nor forsake us. Okay, I've been praying, you know that. I take authority over the devil every day. I still will and still do. But God's bringing me into this thing where he's telling me to proclaim these things, okay? And so then he said, you don't have to do anything, because if you do something, it might get you hurt. It might bring you harm. It might get you in trouble. You don't have to do anything. Live your life, okay? Just be a believer. You're it's going to happen because you're a believer. There will be people that, hundreds and thousands of billions of people that will never see this video. I'm not starting a church. I'm not starting a thing. I don't even care. I don't even care if you know who I am. This is going to happen, okay? And he will do the work, and he will get the glory. And you know what? Because, yes, I know all about the end times, how horrible, and it's supposed to get bad. It's supposed to get bad. But maybe it never got good. Maybe it never, ever got good because we, the body of Christ, never walked in the fullness of God, what God really wanted for this earth yet. And God is needing, God loves people. God loves souls. So people are going to come to God. And so people that believers, the anointing is going to touch and heal and deliver. That anointing of the shadow, people walking down the street, the homeless people that are believers will affect the unbelieving homeless people. People will come to Jesus Christ, okay? And then maybe when God has got every believer, everybody in this earth, every soul saved that he wants, then he'll send Jesus back, and that will be the time when he takes the church out of this world, because it has gotten so bad, okay? And yeah, there's going to be a falling away. That might have already happened. That might already be happening because the tests and trials are so difficult. But I believe this is what God has told me. Okay, now, then he told me, starting with every homeless believer, they be delivered, set free, protected, healed, mental drugs, fed, home, safe, blessed, and the anointing on them spread throughout the unbeliever. Saved, blessed, delivered, healed, fed, homes for the homeless. Because God sees the most, the lowest person. And yeah, he said, you'd always have the poor with you. So this extends up into the highest ranks of life also. Okay, but I haven't written that yet, okay? Believers, this is for believers walking around down the street, shopping, doing business, jobs, driving cars, driving trucks, planes, trains, in their homes, neighbors, neighborhoods, cities and towns, America, around the world. Anointing destroys the yoke. Time is short. I wrote this 19 hours ago on Twitter. Time is short. The devil knows his time is short. It just got shorter. God demolish his kingdom. God demolish the kingdom of hell on this earth in Jesus Christ's holy name. Okay, here we go again. 21 hours ago. God is not asking for your permission, and he doesn't need it for all this to begin to happen. It's already started the day that I made that first video. Now, I'm not, like I say, and you know what, I'm tired of beating myself up. I'm tired of beating myself up, okay? I'm tired of I'm not waiting for anybody to, you know, clap their hands for me. I don't want anybody to put me on a pedestal. I don't want anybody to make me an idol. Okay, like a lot of Christians make even pastors idols and people idols. And, you know, I'm not talking about Joel Osteen and his big church, mega church or anything like that. Leave him alone. Just, you know, God bless him. Okay? You know, people can get weird. Even Christians can get so weird. Oh, you're a woman. You're a woman talking about God and preaching the word of God. Okay? I'm sorry you have a problem, but that's not my problem. That's yours. Maybe you should get some faith and read the book of Galatians, where it says there's neither male nor female. Okay, now I know I'm a female, okay? A lot of people in the world, in politics, can't describe what a female is. Well, I'm a female, okay? If you don't know the difference between a male and a female, I'm sorry. You might have a problem, okay? I'm not coming against you if you're LGBTQ, blah, blah, blah. I'm not getting into all that, okay? You know, I'm not going to promote it. I'm not going to promote abortion, okay, like a lot of Democrats do. Clap, clap, clap. We got to give people the choice. So they got a choice, okay? They already have a choice in their particular states, okay? God is not asking for your permission, and he doesn't need it, okay? And then just 21 hours ago, I wrote, Catholic, Protestant, or any other denomination or non-denomination, there is only one church. Sorry. Sorry, not sorry, okay? There's only one church, okay? Now, I think that's it. I think that's it, and I'm a little exhausted. So, Lord, thank you for this commission. Thank you for doing your work, Lord. Doesn't matter whether anybody, you know, agrees with it or not. It's your deal. I put it in your hands, Lord. And also, another thing, politically, God told me yesterday, I believe, God has been saying this a few days. God is doing a new thing, and that he is going to override some things, okay? I need to write a timeline for all this, but I wanted to share it with you, and this is great. God is doing a new thing, and God is going to override a lot of things. God is going to override some things because that's what he does. He's God, okay? Okay, if you don't know Jesus Christ, you can go to my website, newsandprayer.com, and click on searching for God. There's a prayer in there, or Google, you know, how to become a Christian. You just believe that God raised Jesus from the dead, and that he came to die for our sins. Okay, do you believe that? Maybe you have to think about it some more. Okay, think about it. Think about it. But don't think too long. Like me, it took forever to like analyze it and go. And then one day God took me into a church and I accepted him. I said, you must be who you say you are, the Son of the living God, because I've searched high and low for truth, okay? 8 years of full-time college. There's no truth in it, any of those books I read, okay? I'd searched more than even that 8 years. And I wasn't searching for God during those 8 years. I was just going to college. But God began to draw me and show me there's something out there, and it was Jesus Christ. It's that something that was out there, that was perfect, that was beautiful. Jesus Christ. That was him. And I know people think of religion. Stop thinking about religion, okay? He's a spirit. God is a spirit, and God is love. He loves you, and I pray for God to bless you and anoint you and make things happen for you and deliver you. In Jesus Christ's holy name, amen. Okay, God bless. Love you.